Welcome to Earl Stewart on Cars with Earl and Nancy Stewart, Stu Stewart, and Rick Kearney. Reach them with your questions at 877-960-9960.
Years ago, if somebody was to come in and trade a vehicle at your dealership, they would trade it at, let's say, a $10,000 trade-in, buying a $20,000 car, they would pay the tax on the difference. Is that right?
Yep. That's correct. That's okay. still that
way. Today, we have a variety of dealers that are jockeying to buy your car outside of the purchase. So they just say, we buy any car. So I come over to you and I sell you a Toyota because you're probably going to give me a few more dollars for that Toyota because you're in that business. And then I go across the street to Chevrolet and I buy a $30,000 Chevrolet with a $10,000 sale on my Toyota. So that's a $20,000 difference. But the state of Florida is going to ask me to pay tax on the full $30,000 at the Chevy dealership. Isn't that right?
That is correct.
Is there any way that I could connect those two transactions to where I'd only pay money on the $20,000 difference?
Not really. You're looking at a $600 problem on a $10,000 car, 6% Florida sales tax of $10,000 trade-in. You're losing that deduction of $600.
Well, it also seems to me that the state is partly to blame as well, because the VIN number is traceable. That car that is registered in my name suddenly becomes registered next week in someone else's name because I traded it with you and you've resold it. The state has gotten paid. If it's through you, my trade and my purchase is through you, they're only getting the additional revenue on the increased value of the new car.
Yeah.
If I was to sell my car to Chevrolet and then buy a car from you, then the state's getting taxed twice, and the state is as guilty as these cars dealers are. If I trade through you, somehow the transaction is blessed by the state, and I only pay tax on the difference.
Right.
If I sell it to an individual or to another dealer, and then that person registers the car, now this is a car that taxes have been paid.
Well, the dealer,
now it's re-registered and taxes paid again.
Well, the dealer doesn't pay taxes on cars. It's the retail buyer. So if you sell a car to these folks that are advertising, we buy your car, they're registered dealers. They have a license to buy and sell cars in Florida. So when we buy and sell cars as registered dealers, we don't pay sales tax. When we retail the car, that's when the sales tax. So if you sell a car to a dealer, he takes that car and sells it to the customer, the retail buyer. The retail buyer has to pay that 6%, not the dealer.
Absolutely. But what I'm saying is that the state is aware that my car is registered in my name today. Tomorrow it's registered in a different individual, so taxes is either paid at full price twice, or if it's through a dealer, then only the difference is paid. So the state likes it when I sell my car to an individual and then come and buys the car from you.
Well, if you sell the car to an individual who is a retail buyer, then the sales tax must be paid then by the purchaser.
Twice.
Sometimes people will phony it up, and they will not.
Well, yeah.
And that's
I know about that part. Yeah.
You get in trouble.
Okay. Well, listen. You've answered the question.
Hi, this is Earl Stewart. Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to be notified of new videos that we post to our YouTube channel, simply click on the subscribe button at the lower right-hand side of the screen. Earl Stewart.